One way to improve your data logger programming in CRBasic is with user-defined functions. In this video, we will show you the benefits of functions and how to use them. A function in CRBasic is a block of organized, reusable code that performs a specific task, such as a mathematical calculation, a logical test, or a data logger control task. Functions are defined in the declaration section of the CRBasic program and may be called from anywhere in the program. There are several advantages that functions provide. Functions allow you to define a block of code that can be used repeatedly throughout your program, reducing redundancy and making the program more efficient. Breaking down complex tasks into smaller, manageable parts makes your code easier to understand, maintain, and debug. It also lets you use the same code in different programs and for different models of data logger. Functions isolate complex operations away from the main program, allowing you to use them without needing to know the details of their internal workings. This makes the program easier to follow and lets you focus on higher level logic. Functions create their own scope, meaning that variables declared within a function are only accessed and used within that function. This prevents unintended changes to variable values in other parts of the program. Functions facilitate easier testing and debugging. You can isolate specific parts of your code and test them independently, making it easier to identify and fix errors. Next, we will look at the details of using functions. A function is defined in the declarations portion of a CRBasic program with the keywords function and end function. All the operations you want the function to perform are placed between those two keywords. To define a function, use the keyword function followed by a name for the function. The function name must have fewer than 39 characters and follow the variable naming rules for CRBasic. Parentheses containing optional parameters may be used, but are not required. However, when calling the function from the program, the function name must be followed by parentheses, even if there are no values inside the parentheses. If you don't use parentheses, the function code will not be executed, but will simply return the value determined the last time the function was called. A function is similar to a subroutine, but some of the rules for functions are different. For example, a function returns a single value while a subroutine does not. A function can only operate on one value in an array, while a subroutine can operate on the entire array, and strings passed into a function will terminate when a null character is encountered. In this example, I'm going to create a user-defined function that performs a simple calculation to change engineering units. This is a simple data logger program that measures two thermocouples, one in air and one in water, and returns the measurements in degrees Celsius. I want the ability to switch between degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit for any sensors in my program that are measuring temperature. First, I create a user flag for switching between Celsius and Fahrenheit. I will call the flag SI units. Because this is a flag, I declare it as a Boolean value. And since the program already returns measurements in degrees Celsius, I will initialize that flag with a value of true. When I want to switch from Celsius to Fahrenheit, I will change that flag from true to false and force a call to the function. While I am manually forcing the call to the function, in most cases, the program is written to make that call automatically. Next, I create my function by typing the keyword function followed by the function name. I call this function C to F. I declare a local variable called x to use within the function by putting x inside parentheses. I want this function to calculate 1.8 times x plus 32, which is the formula for converting degrees Celsius to degrees Fahrenheit and return that value. So I type return 1.8 asterisk x plus 32. Finally, I close this portion of code with the keyword end function. In the main program, the thermocouples in air and water are measured once per second and measurements are stored in units of degrees Celsius. After making the measurements, I want the program to decide whether to convert those temperatures to degrees Fahrenheit. So I use an if-then statement to evaluate the user flag and call the function if needed. When I declared the flag, I set it to an initial value of true because when the program starts, units are already in degrees Celsius. To switch to Fahrenheit, I will change the flag called SI units to false, which will force the if-then statement to call the function. This line of code tells the data logger to send the value just written for air temp to the function called C to F and copy it into the local variable called X. When the function is finished with the calculation, it returns the result and stores it in the variable air temp, overwriting the original Celsius value with the new Fahrenheit value. The next line does the same thing with water temperature. Since this is an if-then statement, I need to put an endif here. Now I'm ready to save and compile the program and transfer it to my data logger. The program with the function is running, and here we see air and water temperatures in degrees Celsius. If I click here to change true to false, I now see air temperature and water temperature in degrees Fahrenheit. By default, the function is defined as type float, meaning the value returned by the function is expected to be a 4-byte floating point number. If you want the value returned by your function to be something else, you can change the format of the value returned to string, long, or boolean using the keyword as. For more information about what you can do with functions, see the CRBasic help.